Let me introduce myself. My name is Alexey Mishalkin. I am a scientific researcher of the Institute of Applied Physics. And today I will speak about the direct surface patterning using carbazole baits as a polymer. The work was done in the framework of the joint bilateral project between Ukraine and Moldova. So he presented our organizations. It is Institute of Applied Physics and the Lashkarev Institute of Semiconductor Physics from the Kyiv, Ukraine. So today I would like to tell you about the application of carbazole containing as a polymer materials as recording media for the surface relief formation. Carbazole containing polymer materials and its photoinduced properties studied by our group for a long time. So it was shown that the holographic grating could be obtained in the carbazole materials that involves the exposure of the light interference of the light. And during the holographic recording, several gratings formed simultaneously. First of all, it is the phase grating due to the modulation of the refractive index of the material. The second is the amplitude grating resulting from the change of the absorption coefficient. And the third type of the grating, it is surface relief grating. It's due to the modulation of the surface relief. And usually it is obtained by the selective etching of the materials. Usually it is done by the wet chemical etching, but in our case, as a polymer materials give us a chance to formation to form the surface relief pattern using the light intensity during the holographic recording without any selective etching. So he has presented the molecule of azo dye. It is a basic molecule. It is a carbazole molecule. So during the light exposure, it can transform from the trans form to the cis form. And by heat or another wavelength of the light, it can be transformed into the initial state. So Kim and his group was first group that reporting the surface relief grating formation during the elimination of the material. The rehabilitation of the azobenzene group induces the large scale molecular motions and results in the mass transport of the irradiated azopolymers in films. So he has presented the schematic induced surface relief formation during the exposure of the interfering laser beams. The sum motions of azo molecules are performed, and that leads to the formation of the surface relief. And it should be noted that it is not the laser ablation where the material is evaporated. It is just a photoinduced mass transport effect. So it was discovered in 1995, and just up to now, the many materials are investigated in order to obtain the high sensitive materials for the surface relief grating formation. So he has presented the scheme of our material. We used epoxy propyl carbazole as monomer, and we used dispersed orange 3 byte from the Sigma Aldrich, is commercial available azo dye. And by the chemical polymerization of our monomer and our azo dye, we obtained the copolymer epoxy propyl carbazole with dispersed orange 3. The ratio of polymer and azo dye was 90 to 10. So we have measured the infrared spectra of these materials in order to obtain some absorption bands due to the characteristic groups of these materials. We have confirmed that there are an group, other polymer group, that it is present in the our other polymer. It is not seen in the poor polymer composition. And he has presented the attribution of absorption bands due to the different bonds of the our polymer. So here is presented the our stretch bond, nitrogen bond. So the next step was obtaining of thin films. The thin films was obtained by the spin coating of the solution of our other polymer. The polymer thin films were prepared by spin coating of the filtered polymer solution onto the glass substrate. First of all, it was put onto the glass substrate, and then by rotating, the solution was evaporated, and thin film was obtained. After that, it was dried in oven at 60 degrees for 6 hours. And the thickness of the final film was varied from 200 nanometers up to 2000 nanometers. So he has presented the spectra, absorption transmittance spectra of our polymer films. The set is the substrate. The second curve is the poor polymer films. We can see the interference in the transmittance spectra due to the high quality transparency and the high quality surface of the our polymer films. And the orange curve is a spectra of our other polymer thin films. We can see that it has a large absorption band in the range of 400 up to 580 nanometers. And we used the wavelengths of 532 nanometers. It is the wavelength of our recording laser beam, and it is in the absorption band of the other polymer thin films. And we used the red laser beam in the transmittance region of the polymer material. We used this wavelength for the recording and reading the diffraction efficiency during the holographic recording. So it is, it has no absorption in the our polymer films. So here is presented the setup of holographic recording. We used DPSS laser beam at 532 and 473 nanometers. We used beam splitter to divide our laser beam into two beams. And our sample was put into the interference zone of two beams. The period of the interfering grating is according to this formula. It depends on the wavelength of the laser beam and the angle of two beams that are collimated. So using the red laser beam at 650 nanometers, we used to the controlling the diffraction efficiency growth during the holographic recording. So the higher diffraction efficiency implies the larger surface relief modulation. So recording, so the reading the diffraction efficiency at red laser beam, we can charge, we can judge if the surface relief formation is performed during the holographic recording. So we used several polarization configuration of our recording recording setup. One of these, it is the parallel linear polarization SS. It's vertical linear polarization. The another type of polarization configuration is the linear polarization of recorded beams under the angle of plus 45 degree and minus 45 degree. And the last one, it is a secular polarization of recording beams. It is right secular polarization and left secular polarization. And he has presented the resulting electric field vector pattern in the interference fringe. We can see that the using the linear polarization, linear vertical polarization in the interference pattern, we have no change of the polarization, only the intensity of interference pattern. And the contrast of this intensity is about 100%. But using the another configuration of laser polarization, we have a little contrast of the interference pattern, but the resulting electric field, the polarization in the interference pattern are changing from the linear polarization, horizontal linear polarization up to vertical linear polarization. And in the case of plus minus 45 degree, we have a secular polarization in the interference pattern. So in case of two last cases, we have no light intensity interference pattern on the surface, but the polarization direction changes periodically from horizontal to vertical positions. So he has presented the light intensity distribution in the interference pattern. You can see that for the linear polarization, it has the maximum of intensity modulation up to the two more times intensity.
Hello, I'm sorry. Igor Agaki, please interrupt your microphone.
So in case of another polarization, we have a small modulation of intensity in the interference pattern. So he has presented the modulation of diffraction efficiency independence on the recording time at different states of the recording beam polarization. First of all, for the secular linear polarization, it has the maximum diffraction efficiency up to 3.5 degree of diffraction efficiency. The second one is the diffraction efficiency for the plus minus 45 degree. It's up to 1.5% of diffraction efficiency. And the diffraction efficiency for the linear vertical polarization S and S, we have no growth of diffraction efficiency. So we can say that using the maximum intensity modulation in the interference pattern lead to no surface relief formation. But using the modulation of polarization states of the interference pattern leads to the formation of the surface relief grating formation with the highest surface modulation. So he has presented the atomic force microscopy results of our grating obtained during the holographic recording. So he has presented the grating obtained by the on the film with a thickness of 270 nanometers. And the height of our profile was obtained up to 80 nanometers. So the ratio of surface relief grating amplitude to the thickness is about 30 degree. Of the film thickness, it was obtained for the cases of plus 45, minus 45 degree of configuration of laser beams. And the second slide is the atomic force microscopy images of the grating obtained using the left and light, left, right and left secular polarization of recording beams. Here we obtain the surface modulation up to 130 nanometers, that it is about 48% of the film thickness. It's the highest modulation of the surface of the our polymer films. So we have performed the obtaining of aluminium coating of the grating using the thermal evaporation. So he has presented the atomic force microscopy images of the grating after the aluminium evaporation. We see that it was not destroyed by the thermal evaporation, and the height of our surface relief grating remains the same value of about 130 nanometers. So another type of work was the obtaining of azote polymer composition with magnetic particles. We use iron sulfide magnetic particles. So we studied the holographic recording of this material, of this composition material. So we obtained after the holographic recording both the surface relief grating. It is shown on the left images. The relief profile is close to the sinusoidal one. And on the right side is presented the atomic force image of surface relief overlapped by the magnetic force microscopy map. It is a color map. And it was shown the distribution and value of magnetic field correlates with the period of the grating surface relief that can be used for the creation of surface relief optical elements with unique properties for photonics and in magnetic memory applications. So some conclusions. We report the observation of holographic surface relief grating formation on epoxy propyl carbazole dispersed orange copolymer films without any subsequent processing steps. We also found that polarization configuration like right and left cyclopolarization is the best case that allows us to achieve the surface relief grating with the largest amplitude, about 130 nanometers, that it is about 50% of the film thickness. On the other hand, the linear polarization configuration SS providing the 100% of intensity modulation doesn't lead to the any grating formation. So we conclude that formation of surface relief grating depends strongly on the polarization distribution. And we have shown that the possibility of direct one-step magnetic relief formation during holographic recording these magnetic particles can be used for creation of surface relief optical elements with properties for photonics and magnetic memory application. So I want to acknowledge the project that was supported our work. It is a Secure R2EI project and the bilateral project Ukraine-Moldovian that we done the last years, and thank you for your attention and for your comments and any questions. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you, the presenter. So, if there are any questions, we are opening 2 minutes for question answer section. Okay, so in this case, I will try to have to ask a question if you are ready. So and it is very interesting to make this optical relief on polymers, but there is an interesting, you know, question about how this pattern is changing over the time, or it because it is polymer, so we can expect and core arranging of molecules during the time. Have you investigated the durability of this surface relief?
Yes. We have studied the storage of this obtained surface relief grating up to under the room temperature. It was stable up to 1 year of storage. But in the case of higher temperature, up to 40 degrees, the polymer is fluent and the grating is erased and no surface relief is obtained during the high temperature.
Okay.